Jason is gonna kill Dante unless you stop him.
How am I supposed to do that?
I don't know. Jason's your enforcer. You figure it out. Or the son that you claim to love is gonna be dead.
You know, it's funny. You would think, with all the time I spent with Jason, I know something about guns. I'm sure I know how to point and shoot. Oh, Jason, well, you know, he's lethal with or without a gun. You should take this. You just may need it.
What's the point of carrying around a gun if Jason's as lethal as you say he is? I might as well just sit back and wait for the inevitable.
Yeah, but if anyone can stop him, you can, right? A dedicated cop? Going after criminals no matter who they turn out to be? And the law's always right, so that makes you right.
Well, I wasn't this time. I was wrong, right?
Oh, you knew what was best for Michael. You did.
Look, I can't even believe my arrogance, okay? When I look back on it, thinking that Michael's testimony and my powers of persuasion would be enough to make the judge not put Michael in prison, I mean, I'm sorry for playing with Michael's life like that.
You're sorry. You're sorry now.
Jason wants revenge. I'm not just gonna sit back and let him kill me, but I understand why he feels the need. He has every right to blame me, and so do you, and so does Sonny.
I hate what you did. But you're not to blame for Michael being in Pentonville. I am.
Believe me, I don't want Dante to die, but Jason doesn't care what I think at this point.
If you tell Jason not to lay a hand on Dante...
I already did, back when I trusted Dante to do the right thing and not turn Michael in, and that was my mistake.
He wants to help
Dante
Michael.
Dante told the court that Michael killed Claudia, and now what? Michael's getting 5 years in prison. 5 years!
Dante is tearing himself up about this. He's devastated. Does that not count for something?
You're not getting this. Jason was the one who took Carly to the hospital when Michael was born. He devoted himself to Michael. When Carly got pregnant, he stepped aside and let us give him a great life. Look at the great life that we've given him. I've exposed Michael to violence.
Then stop the violence. If you feel terrible about it, just tell Jason not to kill Dante.
Okay, look. For you, Luke, I'm gonna remind Jason, okay, that Dante is my son and that he's an honest, good person who's just trying to do the right thing. But here's the deal. Jason is best at what he does, and when he has it in his head to kill Dante, no one's gonna stop him.
When I got involved with Sonny, Michael was a baby. I fell in love, and I wanted Sonny to be Michael's father, despite the fact that he was involved in organized crime and lived in a violent world. I told myself that Sonny was a wonderful and caring father, and that's all that mattered, and it made it okay. I'm the reason Michael is in prison. It's my fault because I brought him into that world. Your mom knew better. At 15 years old, she was smarter than me. She kept you away from Sonny so you wouldn't have to go through the hell Michael's going through right now.
Hindsight's 20/20, right?
Oh, I didn't see what was right in front of me. I mean, I hate that you told the court that Michael killed Claudia, but I think I was angriest at myself.
You should be angry at me.
You love Michael, Morgan. I think that's why I liked you from the start. You're always so wonderful and kind to Morgan.
It was easy. He's a great kid. I've broken his trust, probably for good. All because I was so sure. I was so sure I could fix Michael's life. Hell of a job I did, right?
This isn't your fault. You shouldn't blame yourself because of what I did to my son. I'll talk to Jason. I'll tell him to leave you alone. He listens to me when it comes to Michael, so...
with me, love, Jax.
You're upset about Michael going to prison. We all are. This is horrible, and I swear to you that this is the last thing that Dante ever wanted.
You're here about Dante.
I know that you're furious with Dante because you think that he betrayed Michael, but that's honestly the opposite of what he intended. He loves Michael. He thought that the truth was going to save him and get him away from Sonny and the mob, and that's what you wanted, too, right? For Michael to have a chance at a better life.
Yeah, it is.
I know that Dante had only the best intentions, and it's the judge's fault that everything is so messed up right now. I mean, Dante was stunned with the ruling. I mean, you saw him in court. He got up, and he tried to get the judge to reconsider. And now Jason needs to make someone pay, and he's gonna kill Dante. And I know that you're the only person who could do anything.
Stop
begging you.
Just stop.
Please.
I came from seeing Dante. I told him I will not let Jason hurt him.
Hey, bro.
Hi, Katie. How you doing?
Hell of a lot better than Michael's doing.
Donnie, you cannot blame yourself for this.
Who else is there to blame? I mean, I'm the flippin' know-it-all that waltzed into court, thought he could fix Michael's life single-handedly and tried to influence the outcome of a trial? I mean, talk about arrogance.
There is no person alive that could have predicted that the judge was going to be this tough.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. No one could predict that. Michael's fate was not in my hands. I was a fool to think it was. I mean, you know, I'm worse than a fool. I betrayed Michael's trust. I'm a traitor to my own family. I mean, Sonny and Jason and Carly, I'm exactly what they accused me of.
Say that, Dante. That's not true.
You know, now Michael's locked up with a bunch of freaks who are standing in line so they can get a piece of Sonny Corinthos' kid. You know, Jason comes gunning for me. It's the least I deserve.
Say that. If you think that I'm going to stand around and watch you throw your life away, kid, you got another thing coming.
Ma, look, you don't have to gear up to fight anybody right now, okay? You already saved my life tonight. Carly was here tonight.
I can't imagine that was pleasant.
She told me she blames herself for what happened to Michael. That she wishes she never let Sonny raise him. I mean, then she told me she admired you, that you kept it a secret that Sonny was my father, that you raised me away from the mob.
You serious?
I was certainly surprised, but she seemed genuine. I mean, she doesn't like what I did to Michael, but she certainly puts herself at fault. So she's going to talk to Jason, try and convince him to leave me alone. So I'm safe.
You sound disappointed.
It's not like I have a death wish or anything, but I'm so pissed off at what I did to Michael, I'd almost welcome a shootout with Jason right now.
Okay, honey, now you're starting to scare me.
If it wasn't for me, Michael would be free.
Yeah, and even his mother can see that you're not the one to blame. She blames herself for letting Sonny into Michael's life. Honey, Sonny is the problem here, not you. All you did was uphold the law and try to protect your brother. You can't blame yourself that the judge ruled the way he did, and I don't want you questioning what you did.